Hi, welcome to Padhai Planet. So in this video, we have got a question again from quadratic equations. And in this question, what we need to do is we need to find the discriminant of the equation which is given. And we also need to find out what are the nature of these roots, right? Are they real or they are not real, you know, or they are simply imaginary. So we got to find that out also. Now, you know, if we have to find out the nature of the roots, then what we need to do is we need to find out the discriminant of the equation. And the discriminant of any of the quadratic equation is equal to, we already know this, that's b square minus 4ac. That's the formula to calculate the discriminant of the quadratic equation. Now, how do we get the values of b, a and c from this equation? It's very simple that we need to compare this equation with the standard form of the quadratic equation, and the standard form of any quadratic equation is ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. And when we compare this equation with this, we clearly see that the value of a, which is the coefficient of a square, is equal to 3. Similarly, the value of b is negative 2, and the value of c is 13, right? Now that we have got the value of all of these three things, right, we need to simply put them into this formula, right? And we will get the value of discriminant. And we know that if d comes more than 0, then the roots are real, right? And then we can find them also. It is possible to find them. So let's first understand the value of b square minus 4ac. Let's put all of these three values into this formula and we will get that. So it's equal to b square minus 4ac, and b square means negative 2 whole square minus 4 times a, that's 3, multiplied by c, and that's 13, right? So this is like 4 minus 12 times 13, right? So now, like, it's like 4 minus 6, 3 carries, and 156, and that's equal to negative 152. Now, with this, we can clearly see that the value of d is less than 0, right? Because d is coming to negative 152. That means the roots of the given equation, are not real, right? That's the nature of the roots of this equation. So they are not real, and hence we cannot find them, right? So this is how we can explain this question, and I hope this is understandable. And in case you have any of the doubts or something, you can always, you know, be in touch with me and we can take this forward. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.